I was 21 years old when my family expected me to have a mortgage. 21. Yeah. But at the time, it didn't happen. And that's exactly where my mind changed.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My brothers and sisters, what's good?
Mortgages. Mortgages, buying a house. I mean, listen, let's be honest. Growing up, we're always told by our parents, you should buy a house. You need to buy your house. You need to get on the property ladder. And the truth is, we need to take a step back and understand, really and truly, is it even the right decision? I remember growing up being 17, 18, 19 years old, and the goal, the ultimate goal, where I would think that I have hit the like success. Buy a house for yourself, have a good salary, be married, will children, and that's you done. Let's be honest. Let's take a step back and be like, you know what? You're right. Like, that is the ultimate goal in many of our families' perspective. You've made it. If you've got your own house, if you've got your own family, if you've got children, if you've got a good job that pays you a decent salary, in essence, you've made it, right? But have you? Because only the person who is in that scenario, that situation, really knows how they feel. See, your parents or your next door neighbor or your sister or your cousins, they're not going to be paying your bills. And we have to understand, is it really worth it to have a mortgage and get a mortgage and buy a house? But don't worry, this is exactly why I'm here for you guys on this channel. And that's exactly what I want to keep talking to you guys about, the norms of society that people think that, yeah, this is the way how I'm going to get success. But ask yourself the question, how many people would you say, generically speaking, are actually successful and happy in life? A lot of the people are hand to mouth. I mean, that's a stat, that's factual. A lot of the people are hand to mouth. So that's exactly what I want to speak to you guys about. And make sure to like this video if you haven't already. Subscribe to the channel. Listen, we're trying to grow the community and guiding everyone to, inshallah, one day have financial literacy, in the sense where, you know what, think differently, avoid haram, make good money, make hijrah. We're trying to benefit the people, so make sure you join up. But one of my biggest issues with a mortgage is the fact that people don't really understand how much they end up paying over 30, 35 years. A lot of the times you end up paying like 25, 30% interest, pure interest in paying back the loan money. Not only that, but you commit yourself to paying back a certain amount for 30, 25, 30 years of your life. So if you're 25 years old, in essence, what you're saying is, you know what? Yeah, alhamdulillah, I'm gonna be 55 years old and I'm gonna have a house and my kids are going to have a house. Ya habibi, are you living your life for your kids? Like, do you not want to see some comfort in your own life? Do you not want to spend some time away and, you know, genuinely like focus on the deen and give your time to the family and the kids? You know, the biggest thing is like having that big stress on your head. And a lot of people have this, by the way. A lot of people are stressed about paying their mortgage. A lot of people think to themselves, I got bills. I have to pay my bills. My bills will. The higher your bills are, the higher your anxiety is going to get. It's just simple. Though, if you don't have massive, massive bills, guess what? Serious note, you can pack up your bags today. You generally can pack up your bags today and make hijrah to wherever you want. You can move to Pakistan, you can move to Jamaica, you can move to Nigeria, you can move to Dubai. Wherever you want to move to, you can move to. Why? Because you're not locked into a house and paying that money back every single month. Now, you might ask me and say, well, hang on a minute, I could just sell my house and do that. Yeah, but of course, that takes time. And you know, a lot of the times when you're in something and now you're, for example, you're in that contract and that agreement of paying 30, 35 years, you will feel like it's too long. It's too much of a hassle. It's too difficult. I have to sell my house. I have to actually find a buyer. Then I'll get the money. You know, I the element of safety. Now you're comfortable. Do you really want to leave that comfort? Once you're in it, it's much harder to leave. There's no doubt about it. Like when you've bought the house, it's so much harder to now be like, you know what? I'm just going to sell it. Like 6 months later, how hard is it to sell it? It's easier to go to work a job every single day and pay that bill every single month for 30 years. That's easier than to just say, nope, I made the wrong decision and I'm going to close it. And I'm going to sell my house. But is it just that? Is it just the fact that it's so much of a draining energy on your head, the fact that you have a mortgage? Because obviously, my brothers and sisters, you have to live somewhere, right? Now, you guys might be like, well, what should we do? Honestly, just rent a home. Like, it's okay. Rent a flat. Rent somewhere. Why? Because at least you won't have that stress off on your head that you have this mortgage. And rent a flat, rent a home, because it's completely fine to even rent. And you guys might be like, yeah, but I can have a mortgage and equity and I'm building up and, you know. But let me tell you something, my brothers and sisters. As Muslims, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam go on war against the one who indulges in riba. It's a massive sin. It's a huge problem. There's issues with it. We as Muslims cannot have a mortgage
And you can go, you know, and fatwa shop, and you can go find a fatwa that says halal. You know, you probably can find a fatwa that says alcohol is halal. Subhanallah, the internet is, you know, is filled with craziness. But genuine thing, like the biggest argument, and you know, we're going to hear speak me to you, like for real, real, right? The biggest argument about why a mortgage can be halal in sense of it's a void, like it's fine, you can take a little bit of interest, is basically that some people will say that it's a necessity. You need a house, you need to have a mortgage because it's necessity. And we know, let's be very honest, you can rent your house, you can rent a home, you can rent a flat and not have a mortgage. You can, that's fine. If you feel like it's more expensive, by the way, completely, that's not a problem. But the issue here is that's not necessity. That's just more expensive, in your opinion, by the way. But that doesn't make it halal now just because it's more expensive. And there are other claims that are made that, oh, you know what? It's not safe because, you know, the landlord can kick you out anytime. That's not true. These people, unfortunately, have not looked at agreements and how things work. The landlord has to give you notice. And did Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam not tell us to live like travelers? And yet that's completely going against it. Like, we should be living like travelers. Like, we shouldn't just expect and try to be safe and very like, oh, at least I know I'm good for like 20, 30 years. Alhamdulillah, that's okay. But not when it goes against our deen. So my brothers and sisters, I will be very straight with you. No doubt, like a mortgage, I've ran this by many people of knowledge. Like, you know, even though, to be honest with you, it's clear cut, I still feel like I have to go to the people of knowledge because they're the people we learn our religion from, and they have clear cut. It's haram. You can't go. You can't do it. Riba is not a joke. It's a big, major, major sin, basically. So I would say you have to avoid it at all costs. And remember that if you rent, you know, you're trying to like get away from society in terms of the norm, because let's be honest, like it's normal to have a mortgage. Like, what else are you going to do than have a mortgage? The reason why I've created this channel is so someone could tell you, someone could be like, it's okay to rent. You don't have to have a mortgage. In fact, it's probably one of the best decisions of your life that you will make, especially if you want to move away, move to a different country, start a business. Instead of starting a business with saving money for 10 years, maybe £200-£300 a month, guess what? The money that you were going to put into that mortgage as a deposit, now go rent. Go rent on like £1,200-£1,300 a month. Yes, it might be a little bit more initially, but maybe you have £10,000-£20,000 that you could put down on a deposit and start a business. And that business now starts making you £2,000-£3,000. So my brothers and sisters, make the right decisions for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No doubt Allah will open doors for you that you never even thought of. I hope, inshallah, this video benefits you guys. I hope it instills some confidence in you guys. Make sure to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already and share with your family and friends, because I know it will benefit some people. That's all from me today. With jazakallahu khairan, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.